Yes, what is going on? I go by the name of Chris the Capo. This is Link Up TV, the control room, and I am joined by my lovely co-host.
MLavontelle, of course, and our incredible, incredible guests. We got Craig Mitch. Go on.
And I can't forget as well the young goat himself, Flashy Sillah.
Absolutely.
Yes. My G.
Yes, yes.
Craig, if I had you, I would have, you know, bigged it up. Right? I'll start naming a list of everything on that.
First of all, how's everybody feeling today?
Great.
Good.
Yeah.
We've all taken in the album, yeah?
What?
Yes.
What? What?
Have you?
I've digested this album. Are you crazy? It's all I've listened to. Like, I haven't listened to anything else since it's come out. Like, I haven't even switched to other songs or other music. If it happens, another song happens to come on when I'm at home on YouTube, I'd switch it over. This is it.
Like, big man.
Wow.
I'm in the zone.
Okay.
So you've been highly anticipating
it. Well, I'm Hus Hive.
Yeah.
If you're Hus Hive, there's nothing else going on right now.
I hear that.
Like, this is it. There's nothing else to listen to.
I hear that.
But have you always been Hus Hive from the very beginning, or was there a shift?
It was Common Sense album that shifted. I wasn't like in like that before. Obviously, you had the songs, you know, and I thought they were good. But when the album dropped, because I'm a very much an album person, I know this new generation, this songs, singles, TikToks. No, I'm old school, bro. I like albums. I grew up on albums. Yeah. So once I heard Common Sense, I said, this guy's special. Special. Mm. And then Big Conspiracy, I said, super special. Mm. Now I'm locked in. This is it. Mm. Yeah. And I feel like that's the biggest problem we have in the UK as well. I'll be honest. That's our Achilles heel, making projects compared to America. Mm. I think we got amazing spitters. I think we make great hits. We make great singles, all of that. But over the last 20 years, I think our Achilles heel, if I'm being honest, is making projects. We have great projects, but I mean, in comparison to like across the pond, that's what separates them from us, I think.
Yeah.
Would you agree with that?
100%, 100%. But see, me with Hus, because I'm Gambian, I've already got that bias. So when he's spitting certain lyrics, he's not like putting spells on you lot. That's my native tongue.
Are you sure? You're going to need to like Wolof, translate like some of the tunes for us.
I think I'm Gambian as well, you know.
Yeah, come true to
Gambian.
I'll
do a DNA test.
Right. No one has DNA test comes up and it says 4%. Get you love Hus, yeah.
I must be.
That's going to come Stratford, Gambia, all sorts. That's my guy,
literally.
Man. What?
Nah. His twin and all.
Is he like, Ghanaian as well, though, I heard?
No.
Let's not clear that.
He is fully Gambian.
Why are you Ghanaian?
Nah, I just heard that. That's just what I heard.
Okay. Yeah.
But that's what everyone says. I was saying, you do a DNA test and they split it and it's got all these different things going on.
Ghanaians try and claim him, but nah, he's one of us. Like, he's actually, and he looks so Gambian.
Do you blame him?
I feel like he's made it very clear, to be honest.
Yeah.
Anyway, let's talk about the album. Let's get into it.
So for those that are watching right now and thinking, what exactly are we talking about? We are talking about the third album of J Hus.
The GOAT!
Baby, beautiful and brutal yard.
Mm.
Black Butter presents.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to 2K. Shout out to Black Butter every single
time. Come on.
We saw the rollout firstly of the number. Mm-hmm. It seemed as if it was very, very cryptic.
Mm.
The rollout, the don't say militancy. Mm-hmm. We saw that whole rollout, and then it was just like slap there. Hus first single is crazy.
Yeah.
How did you feel in your perspective? How did you see it as? Did you think it was the ideal rollout for someone who's had such a long hiatus, or did it seem like could have done a bit better with the execution?
Do you know what? With Hus, I feel like anything goes. Do you get what I mean? I've kind of got he's the way I view him is like he can't really do much wrong. I can't criticize him too tough because he's just in a kind of league in his own. But that's not to say I like every song he puts out.
Yeah.
That's not even to say I love the album.
Yeah.
But I just feel like I find it difficult criticizing someone like him that's just so unique because you can't even box him.
Mm.
He's like UK Kanye. Like he's just, I just.
That's a big statement.
It is. But I mean, in terms of how he carries himself, his insanity at times, his genius, and his creativity, that's what I mean. Of course, I'm not comparing them in terms of lyrics and all of that jazz. I'm not getting into all that. But I'm just saying in terms of how we're to put two people in a comparison level. But I mean, for me, the album, I like it. I don't love it.
I would agree, you know. I would agree. I think I like it. Out of the three, Hondo is the weakest, bro. Could we agree on that, though?
We were going to do our top five.
It's too early to say, though. Yeah. It's just too early to say, because okay, we've lived with those albums for ages.
Can I ask you, first listen, Common Sense, first listen, Big Conspiracy, first listen, this. What feeling did you get from this compared to the rest? Because I know, bro, when you heard Big Conspiracy,
that's a good question.
I got similar feeling.
Really?
I got a similar feeling, yeah. I did. Do you know what it is? Yeah, you got to understand, yeah. I know you're comparing him to himself, which is cool, even though artists change and develop, but cool. But if I compare him to The Landscape, this is by far one of the best. And this is no disrespect to other artists out there right now. But that's what we're doing. We're comparing him to himself. Because I feel like if a lot of 90% of the UK scene made an album of this quality and this level, you'd be saying it's by far their best work. Like, easily, in my opinion. And that goes back to what I said about us struggling to make great projects over here. Like, a lot of the UK artists I listen to, their projects don't sound like albums. They're not thematic. They're just songs kind of like thrown together. Like, even down to the artwork and everything about this, like Beautiful and Brutal Yard, you can see there's two sides to him. Like, the intro with the step, like, there's, he's
thought
about
this. Doesn't
artwork
remind you of the Common Sense artwork? Like, it feels like Common Sense artwork blown up. Yeah.
That's why he did it. Yeah. You could tell. Like, that's what I'm saying. He thinks about things. Like, I just don't feel like a lot of the other artists think about things. This, to me, this album, I played it as soon as I left his listening party the other day. I jumped in my car, threw it on with my boy. I'm not gonna say I had a couple drinks because man don't drink and drive.
And my man,
I was driving and it just hit. Mm. It was hitting, bro. I got the feeling, I can't lie.
Was it the juice though?
I wasn't drinking, bro. The apple juice don't hit like that. What I'm saying is, see this album, I'll be honest, like, and this ain't even to sound stunty or anything. I know some of you lot, when you played this album, you put on your headphones or you played it off your phone, or you need real speakers to take things in. So I jumped in my car, I had the Burmeister speakers. It was hitting, the sonics were serious. You have to hear albums on certain speakers, you know, because these albums are made on serious speakers in a studio. When people get the album comes out and then they're playing it on their phone like this, like out of a
phone. Don't disrespect the music.
Even if you're playing, some people put it off YouTube on their TV. It's like, come on, bro. And you don't even have a soundbar. So it's like, most people don't even have a soundbar. So
there's no treble, no bass.
TV hitting the wall and then coming to you. There's no sonics. How are you going to hear the instrumentation and the ad-libs and stuff? Like,
which songs for you guys then, did you listen to on this album and you were like, instant hit? Like, you know, sometimes you got to listen 1-2 times to get into the tune. Which one's for you? Let's pick like three.
All right, cool. So Massacre, Hondo, like, for me, that's like a top three pick on the album. Yeah, 100. Would you oppose that?
I could put most in my top three, so I'm not mad.
Okay, true. So I'll say Massacre, Alien Girl for the vibes.
What, are these your favorite or just one?
I'll say if she's asking me for free, I'm giving her free.
What do you say, a hit or top, or his top three?
My top three.
Let's go with top three. Let's
so
go
I'll say three. Massacre, I'll say Alien Girl, and just because I'm Gambian, Come Gully Bun. I wish you lot understood though, like the concept of that song.
Yeah, but I don't even think you have to understand a song to
you
love
know,
it.
Can I say something here? What, with the lyrics here, whatever he's saying in English, he's just translating it into Wolof. That's the language, innit? So obviously it's that. And obviously the return of Boss Belly, do you know what I mean?
Oh, come on.
Like, we ain't seen him outside in a minute. But do you know what, I wanted to say, I feel like the theme of this album's dark, innit? It's a very angry album. Obviously with Big Conspiracy, it was conscious. I got a conscious vibe of it.
Absolutely.
It was more of like a addressing like politics and government. Like, he would literally say that on his album, like those words.
That's so
exactly.
So true, actually. There's a completely different vibe.
Yeah.
Completely different.
I don't know if it's fully dark. It feels like how the artwork, it feels like it's got the contrast. It feels like it has both to me, because there's a lot of girl songs on here. Palm Tree, Nice Body, Alien Girl, My Baby, Freshwater. These are all like girl songs, really.
I think what I'll do is just to jump off of what you're saying, Craig and Flashy, that shout out to Ham, who on Twitter, aka Hams, he tweeted saying, there's a lot of praise coming for this J Hus album.
I personally
didn't wait 3 years to hear one of the best artists in the UK rap in Cruise Control on their crucial third album. No risk taken, no evolution, just plain safe and step below his high standards.
No, let's talk about it.
Pause.
I want to talk about it. Let him add a little bit more.
Adding a little bit of sassoon to it as well. We should have been worried when J5 was not involved and said Hus don't want to focus on subject matter. Instead, we got an album chatting about Usna the whole way through, knowing the standard of songwriting shown on Big Conspiracy, Come On, and then he goes to insert the clip of J5 on the Half Cast podcast. Shout out to Chucky and Poet.
Right.
So what's his name?
Hams.
Yeah. All right. So first of all, your name's Hams. So as a Muslim man, I don't think J Hus is messing with you anyway. Second of all, Second of all, yeah. Man's complaining about man talking about Usna. If you don't get girls, bro, just say that and you can't relate. Like, if you
know,
man that get things relate.
Hus been talking about this though.
Huh?
You don't think it's a little bit lazy?
What is?
Just talking
his
about
take or Hus?
No, what he's saying.
But that's not all he's talking about on here though. But I think it's lazy saying that's all he talks about.
Okay, but he's talking about the girl stuff too.
Yeah.
And he's talking about the dark stuff.
But it's not just that. Because if you listen to playing chess, he's dropping gems.
Okay, true. But that's one out of solid. The whole, he said it. The whole album.
Yeah, but he gave us... See, this is what I'm saying.
No, I'm not even mad at it. I'm just playing devil's advocate.
I know. I'm saying he gave us that on Big Conspiracy. So what I'm saying is, when Kendrick drops To Pimp a Butterfly, super conscious, whatever, then does Damn, which is more pop. No one criticized him.
Yeah.
Everyone was like, oh, this is just great for what it is. When Hus does it, it's like, oh, well, there's no leveling up, or there's no...
But you know we're overly critical in the UK, though? Huh? We're overcritical. So when man are listening to truth, yeah, they're trying to find something.
Yeah, but these man weren't criticizing Kendrick like that. That's my point. UK man wasn't criticizing him like that when he did the same thing. Yeah. Like for me, as an artist, you're going to go through different moods and different. For me, for Hus, he just needed to fall in love with music again, right? Yeah. There was a period where, from what I know, he was out of love with music and he was, you know, away, right? This to me shows me he's in love with music again. He's back. The songs are great. All right, there could have been, like, I'll be honest, there's one subject I was looking forward to him touching on this that he didn't, that I was upset about, and that was being a father.
Yes.
Now that he's had a child, I wanted to hear something about that, because that's something that's happened in your life in the last 3 years.
And also,
you get what
beautiful
I'm saying?
And brutal yard. Like, do you know what I mean? The whole concept of the house and the household, that should have been addressed.
Wanted to hear that. I was looking forward to him talking about that, and he didn't cover it. And I was just like, that's an opportunity miss. So maybe for Hams, Desi has a point there.
I'm happy. I'm happy that you said that.
No, okay. I'm not completely disregarding what I'm saying. I was just running joke earlier, I just think people are just being overly critical because of his greatness. And that's what comes when when Messi hit 50 goals in a season, it was mad. When he hit 35.
They said he fell off.
But he saw the
bit. It was more than everyone else.
Yeah. All the criticisms come from a place of love. Because even the way he worded that tweet, like, he weren't even getting at him. He was just saying it like, I love you, but I just wanted this. Yeah. That's all.
No, wait. What was a couple of the lines in
it? No, he did. He went.
He said he's on cruise control.
He wasn't dissing him. Coming from basically one of my favorite artists, ultimately.
Yeah. Yeah, but he said he didn't take risks, which is cap, because he just did a whole song in Gambian.
Yes. And you can't say he didn't take risks when he speak and wall off in couple tunes. Do you know what I mean? And he's been doing that.
Okay, cool. Yeah, he referred to him as one of the best artists.
Hus's brand is all about taking risks and shock value. So man can't say he weren't taking no risks.
Like, he took risks.
His lyricism is shock value.
What track on here would you say he took the biggest risk on?
Probably the Gambian, because no one understands it except 100%. For Gambians.
So Flashy, do you care to just tell us what he was saying then? What's he getting at on that track?
Like, he said, Wagwan, he's verse started with Wagwan Nakala. Nakala basically means Wagwan. Like, he said, Jigembubon basically means that girl's bad. But like, she's a bad girl. Do you know what I mean? Like,
I've heard him say that a few times.
Yeah.
I like that saying.
Yeah, do you know what I mean?
Boobo. So, don't start using it.
It's a vibe,
I'm saying that to my missus, man. As soon as I kids in the crib, you get boobo. She may look at me and say, dog.
Yeah.
I don't know what you said, but God forbid.
Even Boss Billy. So even that whole concept of that song, they were just talking about girls and how like they can give them headaches and whatnot. Mm. But I think the structure of that song as well is very much Gambian. So I wouldn't expect much people to get it anyway. Yeah. But it's still Hus. Do you know what I mean? The cadence, all of it. But it's crazy though, the whole devil in me, demon in me. I feel like that was a risk as well.
We're gonna get to that because that's a very, very vital point.
That was a risk.
I wanna ask you guys a question. We've all been outside to the day parties, the brunches, you know, the dances that are going on at this moment of time. People will argue and say there are three songs of the summer right now. Yeah. Taliban's, Sprinter, and Who Told You. Mm. We're gonna take Taliban's out of there and focus on the UK side of things. In your personal opinion, what is the track of the summer? Who Told You or Sprinter?
Sprinter, hands down.
Really?
Who Told You? Who Told You? I think Sprinter is a vibe, but I feel like it's slightly too even Barzy for man to hear at a day party.
No, but I'm trying to think of what I've seen reactions
exactly.
to.
Exactly. Have you seen the reaction in America to Sprinter? Yeah,
and the type of dance as well.
In the dance.
It's crazy on TikTok as well.
I'm going to go with Who Told You. Mainly, like what you said, I think Sprint is just a bit too barry. I feel like it's for the younger lot. Like, that's their song. Like, it's not really, no disrespect to them, man, but it doesn't feel that grown,
yeah,
that song. Do you get what I'm saying? I enjoy it. It's cool. But I just feel like if you're 24 and under, then that's your song of the summer. Do you get what I'm saying? Like, that's a younger generation song. Central C appeals to them. He's running things in that market. But I'm going with Who Told You. I didn't even give you my top three.
Oh, yeah. Go through, my guy. Sorry.
My top three, number one, right now, because obviously it can change, but the way I'm in the moment right now, Masculine's number one.
Okay.
Masculine's number one. Number two for me was Problem Fixer. And number three for me was Nice Body with Georgia Smith.
It's a very unorthodox pick.
Yeah.
I'll be honest.
Why?
I think in the sense of where it's you. And that's what you personally will end up.
No, like. But I want to know why you think it's unorthodox. That's interesting.
Because a lot of people will go with the singles more likely.
Yeah,
they'll pick the safer options. Yeah. I think with people's picks of the album, it depends on what you personally are into and what you like. So if I'm a Barz person, I may say that I like Come Back with Vils. I may like Massacre. I may like
Come Look,
and things along those lines. Mm. Whereas if it's just for, you know, if it's just Gallum vibe, I may like a Nice Body, I may like an Alien Girl, I may like My Baby.
Do you know what it is? The first 2 days, My Baby was my song. I don't know, I must have been in my feels.
My
I
Baby
don't know,
is
man.
A tune, and it's like them songs.
You
like
know, if you're with
a
one shorty
like
though,
it.
What are you playing on that album?
If I'm with a shorty?
With a one shorty.
My Baby.
Yeah,
My Baby's a tune still.
You don't have Alien to listen Girl. To it twice. Yeah. You like it instantly, that's the thing. It's an instant like.
Yeah,
100%. Going off as well, if we're talking about Who Told You, the Drake verse.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure we were all online and we saw the feedback that people were saying about the Drake verse.
Yeah.
Aubrey came and just ruined the song. We saw the meme as well of the reaction, the fake reaction towards it. What was you guys' opinions on it? Did you think that the Drake verse was really that bad or not?
I'm gonna say it didn't ruin the song. So all of you lot that are saying it ruined the song, to me you're exaggerating, right? Did it elevate the song? No. He didn't elevate it. When you hear Drake, you expect him to just take a good song and then take it to the next level. Like, he's done that so many times. Like, even last year with his verse with Future and Thames.
Yeah.
Cold, his verse on that song. Like, he did his thing.
His verse with Heady One.
Heady One, a couple years ago. Yeah. They expected him to elevate it. I don't think he elevated it. I thought it was just mediocre, if I'm honest. But to say he ruined the song, that's just cap. Maybe it was a bit too long. Because he started saying, what was it? What he kept saying?
Trouble find me
like 10 trouble. Times. Yeah, that was jarring. That didn't need to be that long.
Okay,
trouble gone find
so
me.
Black,
trouble.
Black or white? Like, why is it he did shit or it was really good? Bruv, he complimented the track.
It just got through, basically.
Yeah. Like, it's not like he improved it or made it worse. Yeah. He just complimented it.
I don't think it was bad at all. I think those first 6 to 8 bars on the song are hard. Like, but yeah, it just went on for a bit too long, maybe. That was it. And he didn't, I get what people are saying, he didn't really stick to the theme of the song.
Yeah.
But can he, though? Because he's not really bringing, I know he talks gun talk sometimes and he shouldn't, but he's not bringing a whap in the dance. Like, so
wait, Chris, what was your question, by the way, when you was comparing Sprinter and Who Told You? Was it, what's a club banger or what's your
track of the summer?
Track of the summer.
Yeah.
But based on you or based on the reception?
Based on you, what you personally see.
Oh, okay.
See,
like, okay, then I stab with my answer then.
Can I ask you guys what you think about the Drake feature though? Like, did you think he complimented? Do you think he improved the track or whatnot?
I think he just sailed through it. Yeah. Same. Like, I don't always see it. I'm not that critical on Drake on these type of songs, because I just see the song as just a party kind of commercial song anyway. Yeah. So how am I critiquing it that deep when the commercial songs aren't even that deep, really? Mm. Do you get it? They're just to play in the shops, to play in the clubs. They're not supposed to be taken that seriously anyway. So facts. I didn't really care personally.
It was just a big moment, and I felt like people, that's what I'm saying. You know when people say the UK can be bad vibes sometimes? It can, because it was just a big moment. Facts. It's Hus and Drake coming together. Exactly. We should have just celebrated it. Like, it wasn't bad, so why are we complaining?
Since O2. Huh? Since he came out from the O2, we wanted that.
Yeah,
that,
and they did it. And I thought it was a good song. Like, I don't know what, like, people,
what they want. No, yeah, facts. Like, I don't know what people want.
I don't know. Maybe they might go again in the future and do bars. Like, who knows?
I think it was a different pattern. What I like is, I like when people attack tunes with such a different styling and they have a different pocket that they get into on the actual song. And shout out to Getz, because I remember I had a conversation with him about this and he said exactly the same thing of where the pocket was so unorthodox, he likes that.
Mm.
It was a different approach that he took towards it, and I thought, you know what, I understand. That's what Getz said about Drake's verse.
Oh, okay.
And for someone of that magnitude to say something like that and, you know, reiterate that, then it's just like, okay, cool, this makes sense.
Chris, you didn't answer the question.
Oh, what? I like it.
No, no, it was it was between the two.
Oh, come on, man. For me personally, I would say, who told you? Sprinter for me is too wordsy. Like,
I love Sprinter.
In a dance.
I do like
tune. I've grown to like that song a lot.
I love
That's not my favourite song on that EP. Mine's UK rap, personally, but...
Yeah. But I love Sprinter. I love it.
Looking through the album, obviously executively produced by TSB.
Yep.
Shout out to TSB every single time. First time with him executively producing a J Hus album.
Yep.
Yeah.
Big up to the whole team every single time. Along with that, IO, P2J, amazing impact. EY, Maestro the Baker, Levy, Lennox, Venna, The Elements, Fumes, Lekka Beats, Sammy Soso. We asked the big question. Was J5's presence missing from this album?
Yes!
It was.
Yes!
It was missed. We can't lie and say it wasn't. Like, the magic they've made over the years, I would have wanted some J5 in there. Even if it was just sprinkled, just one track, I do think it was missed.
Yeah.
But still, for me, solid.
Mazik, I'm going to ask you a question as well.
I want to ask you guys a question, actually.
Okay.
Go on then.
Ladies first.
I just want to throw this out there. And Chris, you got to get involved in this one, don't you?
You know, I'm trying to sit politically correct, but I could do it.
He worms his way out.
Yeah, he does.
I don't mind. I'll say everything.
You know, he's really good at it as well, because sometimes I don't even notice. Like, anyway, to all of you guys, if you had to press delete on one song on the album, which song are
Bim
you choosing?
What?
Bim Bim.
That was quick. You must hate that song.
Bim Bim or Killy.
That song is cold.
Bim Bim or Killy.
By the way, I'm with you on Bim Bim.
Bim Bim or Killy.
Oh, you're with him on Bim Bim?
Do you want me to elaborate?
Have you heard that beat?
They're bugging. They're bugging.
Can I be honest with you? The second half of Bim Bim saves it. The second half of it saves it.
What, when the beat changes?
When the beat
changes. No, I like the first half.
The second half saves it.
Oh, we got different. Okay.
And also, with regards to Killy, Popcorn and Burna Boy are two artists that when you have them on a feature, you cannot waste that in any way. That's single worthy material. Anything Popcorn touches, it ends up being gold.
So basically, same, it was a waste. Burner,
anything touches gold. I heard that tune and I said, this is filler. This is filler. And it's so annoying because it's someone of such a high magnitude that I hold Hus to, and Popcorn, I hold him to such a high magnitude as well. And when I listened to that, I was just like,
I'll be honest. I think, and it pains me to say, because I'm half Jamaican, it is Popcorn. It's Killy and Popcorn, that song. Like, when
that's
I saw that
you're
and I clicked
that
it,
one.
That if that's if I had to,
yeah, if you had to,
it is that one. And I love Popcorn, so it's difficult, but it didn't for me. It didn't deliver.
Yeah, it didn't
deliver the heights it should have for them to.
Yeah, I'll say Problem Fixer, to be honest. Yeah, I'll say Problem Fixer.
Favorite songs. What?
Yeah, I thought that was a bit of a filler track.
The Problem Fixer. What?
Yeah. Yeah, nah, because I feel like I've heard that
I don't
before
like mixing
on Hus's projects
mixture
anyway. Like, I like that bar though, but I would say Problem Fixer though.
What?
I feel like between, I listened to it again on my way here. Yeah, I think between Freshwater and Killy, that was the weak spot.
Freshwater.
I was going to say Freshwater.
Nigga
that was what
raps.
I
might have been
before
he
said.
Horny nigga raps.
Yeah. Between Freshwater, so you're saying My Baby and Problem Fixer?
Yeah, My
you're
Baby.
Bugging.
This was the weak
you're
point.
You're bugging.
Wait, what?
From
you're
here
bugging.
To here was the weak point.
He said between these two. So you're basically My Baby and
weak.
Problem Fixer. No,
yeah,
you've lost
like,
your mind.
Freshwater to Killy.
You've lost your mind.
Nah,
what was weak about it? No, no, no. Elaborate. What was weak about My Baby?
By the time My Baby came, I already heard My Baby.
No.
Where?
It doesn't sound like it.
Where? I feel like I heard it with Palm Tree, and I feel like I heard it with
It doesn't sound like anything else.
Flashy,
you
don't love woman. You don't love woman.
My Baby.
You don't love woman.
I played that in the car with my female brethren, and she was loving this song.
See, this is a man that loves woman.
No, because it's...
This is somebody who loves woman. You don't love woman.
I'm telling you, My Baby is a serious... I'm upset about Problem Fixer. I can't believe you said that. What, just because it sounds like something he's made before?
Yeah. I feel like I've heard it before from Hustle. I feel like the one liners, I was like, okay, all right, man. Next track.
I'm not jacking that. This is by voice, obviously it's your opinion. Yeah, for me it's Killy and Cum Gully Bun. Sorry, man.
Oh my
I'm
God.
Sorry, brother. I don't understand it. I do not understand that. That
don't
can,
lie, woman.
That
don't
can
lie.
Go.
Did you get a
and I'll be honest, Alien Girl. I'm not a fan of Alien Girl. I'm not a fan of Alien Girl.
I don't know if I need to listen to it a bit.
Yeah,
more,
I like the metaphor. I see what he was doing, but to me it was just
Mr. Nas is my goal. You don't like Alien Girl.
Yeah, because it's just a bit like when he said, come to Uranus, like it was just, I don't know, man. It was just like, then I put in your, I don't know what he was saying, but
yeah.
I don't know. Like I said, Let me be very clear. I like all the songs. I'm talking about the weakest here. Like, I could listen to all of them.
Right. Yeah,
But yeah, for you to say My Baby and Problem Fixer, to me, that's crazy.
Yeah, I love
My Baby is a huge tune.
Just to ask you as well, Mizik, yeah, going back to the producers. It's funny because Craig and Flashy both said that they felt like as if J5's presence on it was missed.
Yeah, definitely was missed.
Funny enough, you've got the likes of IO and TSB that are a part of the production team that have worked previously on Common Sense, that have worked on Big Conspiracy, and they've worked on the significant big tunes as well from both albums. Couldn't you say that they both covered that? And with having P2J, who's had the credible success with Wizkid, with Burna Boy, with like all of these, with even with Krypton Cones, like with Stormzy, with all of these people, wouldn't you say that they covered it and made sure that you didn't miss J5 that much?
Listen, they did their thing, of course. Those two are so talented, Toby, Ayo, they are super talented, and they delivered. Mm-hmm. I don't think anybody is going to take that from them.
Yeah.
But you can't say just because it's them that they covered for J5. He is his own person. He brings his own flavor to the project, and it just cannot be replicated. It cannot be imitated. It's just that's what it is.
J5 is he's special, man.
Like, very special.
I was even on the way here, I was listening to my mind's gone black. What's the last song on Burna Boy's Twice as Tall? You can bank on it.
Bank on it, yeah.
The production on Bank on It is that the production on, I know you weren't expecting that one. The production on that is crazy. Even all the production he does like for NSG. Mm-hmm. And shout out to NSG. I love NSG. Like Petite, that's my song. Mm-hmm. See them beats though. I like even Petite. Sometimes I listen, I'm like, if J Hus got hold of this. No disrespect to them, they do their thing. Like I love Petite as a song, but sometimes I listen to J5 beats that he gives to other people, and I'm like, if J Hus got hold of this.
Yeah. But do you think he probably gave it to Hus, and Hus was like, "Nah, I'm right, I'll do something."
No, if he got that Petite beat and gave that away, that's crazy.
Yeah.
That beat is crazy. That beat, but like I said, I think he's. Listen, TSB to me, that's my guy, and thanks. I love TSB. And to be honest, J Hus's Daily Duppy, the one TSB produced, is my favorite Daily Duppy ever. Mm. Ever. Ooh. It is my favorite Daily Duppy. It's one of my favorite UK freestyles ever. Mm. Yeah, it's in my top three UK freestyles ever. Think about how many freestyles there's been.
Yeah,
that J Hus Daily Duppy is. Mm-hmm. I know we're on Link Up, but. I'm sorry, Rashid.
Listen, man, it's all culture. It's all the culture.
It's cold. It's cold. Yeah. That's TSB's. I think they got a good synergy, man. Yeah. Like, I get it. People want J5 there, and with good reason, because of the projects they made. But I think TSB, this was a solid project, man.
I think. P2J and TSB. Yeah, I feel like it's just they put their best efforts forward, didn't they? And I think the standard was so high for what J5 set for Common Sense and Big Conspiracy. I'm not saying. Actually, I am saying it was subpar to that.
Yeah.
The production was subpar. Let's not gloss over it. Like it needed that J5 magic to it. Do you know what I mean? That's what we know J Hus for. But for me, J Hus without J5 is like Kendrick without Soundwave. Do you know what I mean?
Drake without 40.
Drake without 40.
Is that what we're saying?
Yeah. Nas without Hit-Boy. Nowadays. Because I couldn't imagine, a Nas album now in 2023 without Hit-Boy.
No, I'll take one with Premier still, but...
I don't think Premier can even match up to Hit-Boy with Nas right now.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? No, but I feel like that J5 magic, it needs to be with Hus. No, as long as he's on Black Butter, give us our free albums with J5.
No, see, we got to stop doing that. We got to stop doing that. We got to allow artists to work with other producers. We got to allow artists to tap in with other producers, man. We can't be just like locked in this mode where they have to be with them. Like that's like saying, bro, I love Future with Metro Boomin.
Yeah.
But come on, man. I got him with Zaytoven. I got him with other people, man. Like, let them.
When you put it like that.
Let them cook a bit, man.
But talking of the albums, because you keep kind of comparing Big Conspiracy, Common Sense, like, where are we ranking now? His three albums. They're all 3 years apart.
Yeah.
They're all out now. Where are we putting them?
Oh, this is so hard.
Big Conspiracy is the best.
Number one.
Big Conspiracy. I think that's the best UK rap project to come out of the last 5 years. Hondo.
Big Conspiracy.
Big Conspiracy, Common Sense, then, of course, is Baby. Of course. I think Baby's an easy third.
Flashy.
Easy third.
I'm
the best album to come out in 5 years.
Yeah, the last 5 years.
What,
yeah,
Big Conspiracy.
Yeah.
I'm not mad at it.
Yeah,
100%. I'm not mad at it. I'm
what would you pick?
If it's just rap. Just this
UK,
on rap.
UK. UK. Yeah.
We're not talking grime.
Yeah, no.
Let's not do that. Let's just say UK, UK black music. UK black music.
Okay, yeah. I like that. The ones that you could mention.
No,
just get to the point. You got something in your head.
Because you were upset with his best. Yeah. So what's the best in your eyes?
conflict. If not conflict,
I gave you that. You can't say that.
Okay, cool. Conflict of interest.
Well, yeah.
Okay, cool.
If not, you can talk hoodies all summer.
Huh?
Hoodies all summer.
Nah, not for me. Not for me.
See, you might.
Bro, I do love that song with Popcorn though.
That's grown man.
The video
man.
Is crazy.
That, do you know what hoodies all summer is? Yeah. That's grown man wearing Birkenstocks with no with no socks type music. That's Sunday morning.
Yeah, but Joy is Kane's changed the way he spits now, and the way he spits from when I grew up on Kane is different. Mm. It's good still, but it's just not.
That's why I say conflict.
It's
for me.
Change.
Conflict for me is definitely.
Where was you back then?
Yeah,
where was you
back then? Conflict for me is the best. That's the
fair
best.
Where
album.
Are you ranking the albums
I'm
then?
A big conspiracy.
Okay, so same. For me personally,
that's an evil.
He's
gonna
do the same one as me, but go on. I can see it. You're gonna do the
Craig,
same.
Craig, I'm trying my best.
Wait,
not
to,
brother.
To me, whisper to me.
All right.
No, don't. No. Why are we?
Because I don't want you guys to say the same thing.
Ah, that's cheating, man.
What do you mean? But I'm gonna say the same thing because I can feel it.
Yeah, okay.
Should I give mine first?
Yeah, go on, because I know his now.
All right, let me give mine first. So number one is Big Conspiracy. Mm. Number two is Baby.
Wow.
And I'm putting Common Sense third. Wow. And the reason, and can I just explain why before people like literally drag me across the timeline and onto Threads as well and drag me across there and then drag me onto
Craig
wherever.
Mitch doesn't know music.
Isn't it? Common Sense, yeah, it's special. Like I said, it's the album that made me really love J Hus as an artist, yeah. But I just think that his bars now have got to another level. Like, I think on Common Sense, he could spit. Don't get me wrong, he could spit. But I can see he's a bit older now with the way he's spitting. He's developed his bars a bit more. They're a bit more polished for me. Like, the things he's saying, it's a bit more clever, is what I'm trying to say.
Mm-hmm.
That's literally what it is.
Okay.
And I love bars.
Mazik, do you want to tell Craig?
No, go on. I'll just be there to vouch for you.
All right, give me the ad-libs, yeah? All right, cool. Even if you don't support what I'm saying. All right. First one I'm going to say,
yeah,
and you're going to cuss me for this. And they're probably going to rip it to
me as number
well.
One. What's number one?
Baby.
Oh, wow. For fuck's sake.
Wait, so you love this album then?
I really
bro,
love this
come
album.
On, man.
Yeah, do you know what? He never said it if he
I
actually
really
loved
love
this
yeah,
album.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I like this. He was waiting for this climax. Yeah, this
I
is a good
really
climax.
Love
I like
bro,
this.
It's been like
I
six
really,
days, bro.
I really love this album. Do you know why? Or can I say
no, the order. Do the right. order first.
It's exactly like yours, but I've swapped the order of the first
so Common Sense is last.
So Common Sense is last. Okay. Right. The reason why I say this is with this album, I feel like as if, as you said, there's that maturity and growth, and also as well, Hus is in such a comfortable space of where he can show us character. Mm-hmm. And I don't feel like that character's previously been shown in the last two. Mm-hmm. On this one, we get funny bars like, she eat me like yummy yummy yum. Yeah. Like there's
bits, move like yummy yum.
You feel me? And then it's like there's certain parts of growth, even towards, okay, as we said, yeah, there's horny guy raps in here, but even with little things as it turns from, in the skit where he says, Hus, what happened to you can't eat pom pom and draw my zoo? And he's like, bruv, growth, innit? Growth.
Yeah,
Just little things. I'm not saying that because they'll clip that and say, that's the only reason why he likes it. But I think also as well, it's like, it's a oxymoron. This album's an oxymoron. Of the light is very light, the dark is very dark.
Mm.
And also it's like the two, I feel like as if he's encapsulating the elements of his mind right now of where it's sort of a battle of good and evil.
Yeah.
Of where I'm catering to the females and everything, but the same way I've got these demons from my past that I'm still fighting with to this day.
Yeah.
Not just because of my lifestyle, but because of being in the forefront to everybody as well.
Yeah.
Mm.
Big Conspiracy, I love that just sonically.
Mm.
We didn't get a chance to really live with it as much because lockdown happened straight away. We only got Must Be.
Yeah.
Mm. Must Be was the only song that got played outside and then everything was locked off. The first two songs, I still feel like they're the best Hus songs ever.
Mm.
And
what songs?
The first two songs of Big Conspiracy.
Oh, was that Helicopter and Fight for Your
Helicopter
Right?
Helicopter and what was the first?
Is it Fight
one?
For Your Right?
I don't think it was Fight for Your Right. You know,
was it fourth?
Less.
It's called Big Conspiracy. It's called Big Conspiracy.
Yes, it's Big Conspiracy. Yeah.
Where, sorry, by the way, sorry. Where was his sister on this album?
Where was he? Yeah, that's
where true. Was she on this album? Because she went crazy.
We're gonna talk about
he's
that.
He soft launched
well.
Her, and then that but was it.
Yeah, to answer your question, I would say those are my three.
I'm looking at Common Sense right now,
Common
and Common Sense is definitely
bad.
Third. It's
you
definitely
think it
third.
Bad?
It didn't age
it
bad.
It didn't age bad.
It didn't
it's just
age
the
bad.
Others aged so
have
much
you not
better.
Listened to it recently? Like,
yeah. I still listen to it.
It has aged a bit.
There's more songs that I could do without on there.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
what it is.
There's a lot of songs.
Do you know what it is? The highs.
I'm not trying to hear that,
bro. The highs on Common Sense are very high, bro. Like Friendly Spirit, obviously Did You See, Boof Daddy, like the big singles are very, very high, but
we need to talk about the collabs though.
Yes.
Ooh. Let's talk about the collabs. And did he hit? Did he miss?
The collabs.
Majority
delivered.
Of collabs did
they
work?
All hit, apart from Popcorn.
Drake, yeah. Naira Marley.
Shout out my Killy Popcorn.
Georgia
though.
Smith, Burner Boy, CB, yeah. Vils, Popcorn. Vils Boss, is Belly.
Vils has been cold though. Vils has been cold. I like
he,
how he.
For when he had the normal cut. For yeah. Before the plaits, before the dreads, well, Vils is.
Like, can we just say though, a lot of people out there are saying that Vils and CB both spun J Hus on those songs. That's just not true.
It's just not bias true. Aside though, they held.
Vils did, CB didn't.
Listen, CB went crazy. Mm. I'm giving him his props. He went crazy. I still think J Hus took it though. That's going to be the unpopular opinion on
Who
that
one.
Who
do you guys think was missing off the album? Anyone you guys would have liked to have seen?
His sister.
Definitely, definitely.
His sister. I would have wanted to see Wizkid on there, you know.
Wizkid?
Nah, not yet. Yeah. Not yet.
Nah, man, he's...
Because and, every Wizkid, like...
Him and Burner locked in, man.
Yeah.
Oh, do you know, I would have liked to see Thames on here.
Okay.
Yeah. I would love to have seen Thames on here.
Yeah, that would have worked.
I'm a big, big Thames fan. Thames?
Yeah.
Nah, Thames would have worked still.
I love Thames. I mean, Thames would have been Thames in him because obviously we've seen him do it with like Coffee, him and Coffee on Big Conspiracy. That song was
God, that is one of my favorites.
Crazy rhythm that song, and I feel like him and Thames could have.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They could have got something in there. Like
I think she could have been on Nice Body.
No, I like Georgia and Nice Body though.
But Thames could have taken that though.
No, we could have had both.
Because it's a kind of drilly type beat.
Yeah.
I don't think that would have suited.
It was like soft drill.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. I think Georgia suits that because she's UK.
Georgia on those up tempo sounding type tunes. Yeah. All of Georgia's best songs have been up tempo.
She does them both well. I think.
I'm not disputing it, saying she doesn't, but I'm just saying.
I love the song she had with Giggs as well.
She kind of spun him, G. On that was a Giggs, you're my goat, but
yeah, I never said it.
She spun him one day.
She spun him one day.
But she went crazy, though. Even in the video in the Range Rover, she was whipping. I was like, I want to be a passenger prince. I want to be a passenger prince, bruh.
Do you feel like as if the nostalgia that's covered in here, of where he's covered the present, the past, the present, and the future of having someone like Boss Belly, if you know, you know. Vils, if you know, you know. CB, who had his moment, if you know, you know. That this is shedding light on them, and also is very selfless of Hus to shed light on them as well. Do you feel like he done that strategically of saying, no, I don't want to get this popular person who's got 100 million streams right now. I'd rather get Boss Belly. I'd rather get CB. I'd rather get Vils because these are people from my walk of life.
No, I respect that though. And my thing is, as long as it works, which it clearly did, he did his thing. I think that's more effective as well because then you're actually giving someone else the opportunity as well. So... Yeah, I'm happy with that.
I thought it was sick the way he did that.
In terms of, go on.
Normally when I hit, like, when I see the track list, like prior to like the album coming out and whatnot, like for all artists, like I think, this feature, I don't know if it'll work. I don't know if this will work, but I trust Hus's judgment and like, his decisions for the futures. Like, I think, and you know what it is, he you can tell that Hus is just anti. Like, I'm bringing my people in anyway, regardless. And the people that are actually rating music in this whole world that I'm in, I'll put them on. You know he's not with the whole like, because my man's doing numbers in the charts or rare. Like he wouldn't just put Fredo on because it's Fredo. You know what I mean? Like he will choose who he wants. Boss Belly can do the job Fredo's doing.
Yeah.
Flipping CB can do the job that Rare's doing. You know what I mean? So yeah, that's why I respect it. I would have wanted to see thing on there though. What's my man's name? Fuck man. Forgot his name. It'll come back to me.
Do you know what? I would love to know what songs didn't make the cut. Because obviously they probably recorded 20 or 30 songs maybe and they have to narrow it down.
That's it. I would have wanted to see
R.A. Okay.
I think that would have been a good contrast though.
Do you look at that feature list and feel like those features on there are a quick summary of who Hus is as a person? You've got Boss Belly who covers the Gambian aspect. You've got CB, Newham, Vils, Stratford. You've got Drake, which is just like superstar stardom. You've got Georgia Smith who covers that other side as well, that also are big fans of Hus. Burner Boy, Naira Marley, like the whole African influence as well. Popcorn, obviously us being in such a multicultural city where the African and we're African, but there's so much Caribbean influence that we have in or around us as well. Do you feel like those features encapsulate him?
I love the fact that he did that because that was one of the things I was raving on about with Big Conspiracy. The fact that it had no music videos,
minimal features
just before, hardly any features, no features as in his peers of UK rappers in the scene. and it did what it did, I thought that was sick. And I wanted him to come back for this and kind of be a bit more
reaching social.
Out. But you can see that he's still anti to a lot of you man out there. Mm. Facts. He still don't fuck with a lot of you man out there, clearly.
Couldn't you say the party showed that the other day? The party that we went to the other day showed it. Yeah. Man, that was a strap. Shout out all you Stratford,
no,
man.
I heard that was Eastern.
Shout out Stratford. Yeah. I didn't really see no UK rappers in there.
I'm so happy that Stratford
he
had
doesn't
a dance.
Mess with no one.
I'm so happy, bro.
He is so anti, and I love that. I actually love that. Like, Boss Belly's Gambian. So it's like, yeah, you can.
I would have wanted to see Parsalu, though, at least.
Hey, free my guy, man.
And I feel like, one thing I want to say, he's locked up. But a one verse must have been there in the studio.
I don't want to do all this. We saw that with Young Thug's album. I don't want to do all this copy and pasting stuff now, man. I need to be out of prison and laying vocals on what they're actually going through. Yeah. But that's the thing. Another thing, just to shout them out, like Boss Belly, Vils and CB, like, even for them, and obviously I don't mean this in a patronizing way, like, I think it's so sick that they can even be in ends and say, I'm on a project with Burner Boy, Drake, Naira Marley, like, these are superstar heavy hitter people. Do you get what I'm saying? And say you're on, this is a piece of history, man. This is J Hus's third album, and they're a part of that.
Yeah, facts.
In terms of the content of the album, before we move on to like charts and stuff, do you guys feel like you actually learned something new from Hus about him?
He's a horny guy, bro.
Is that all you took?
I'm joking. I just know how far he can go with his lyrics, innit?
So you don't feel like there was any new kind of content? Because I agree. I feel like he should have spoken fatherhood, to be honest.
Yeah.
Maybe just
that
not ready.
That was the thing I was looking for. Maybe.
Maybe just not ready.
Maybe.
That was the thing I was looking for. But you got to be... this is what we got to do sometimes as music fans. Because it's like... See, I know I used him as an example before. But I use him because I see similarities in Kendrick and Hus, right? Obviously, Kendrick don't do the crazy gun stick knife in man's thing. But he does different voices. Yeah. He can be conscious. Do you get what I'm saying? Like, and... Kendrick, I always say with Kendrick, my favorite Kendrick, he's long gone.
Yeah.
This guy today, I don't really know who he is. But I'm not mad at it. I'm not mad at it, but I don't know who he is. See, Good Kid, Mad City, I love that. And if he made something like that today, I'd probably tune in a bit more, right? Mm. But that's what I'm saying. With Hus, it's like, that's why I'm not mad that he's giving me this, because this is Hus. This is unapologetically Hus at his core. Yeah, I would have liked to seen the touching on fatherhood, like I said, but... Everything down to the Bunda references, to the Usna, to the Hustler Baby. This is just comeback. I'm back.
For me, it's like, this is the Hus we know. So when people are like a bit disappointed and whatnot, I'm thinking, okay, you wait 3 years. He's giving you what you know already for Hus on crack. Do you know what I mean? Because like, for me, he just sounds, this project is mad angry, innit? It's very angry, it's mad violent. Mm. And we've been seeing that from all the snippets, all the lead up and whatnot for the past like 2 years, bro. You could tell, you would think this guy's off the rails. So when this has come now, it's like, all right, I showed you guys why I've been off the rails. Here's my story, why? Do you know what I mean? Hold it. Even the performances at his party and whatnot, bruv, he's coming scruffy and rare, look like he just woke out of bed.
No trim.
He's right now, he's in the era of, I don't give a fuck, hold that.
And do you know why it looks even more cold? Because it's like, all of the people that are in the conversation with him right now, so... The Senches, the Daves, the Stormzy,
the four-headed monster,
even the Skeptors, huh?
The four-headed monster, you'll call it right now.
Popular. Yeah, yeah. All them guys, they're all in their flashy bag right now. Mm. Their whole thing is watches. I make this much money. Mm. Even Dave is on the stunting thing right now. Dave's stunting. By the way, I love stunting Dave.
That whole project was him stunting.
Yeah, I love stunting Dave. I actually love stunting Dave. I think I prefer stunting Dave's conscious Dave. Yeah. Maybe that's controversial.
Really?
I don't know.
No, not really.
But I love it. But they're all in their stunting bag. Like, even Stormzy now. Stormzy's wearing designer now when he used to be a tracksuit guy. Like, Hus has said, I'm doing opposite.
Mm. Completely
I'm here, white
opposite,
tea, no trim, no jewels. I don't need to do none of that.
I'm just here with my Stratford guys.
Yeah. Music.
Not one chain on his neck.
Not one chain.
Colors. Ugliest jacket and a ring.
Yeah.
No, but it pisses
That's
me off.
That's it.
Though.
No trim. What?
Why is man coming like that, bro?
What?
Nah, man.
He's
getting like
trim,
it.
Bro. Like,
nah.
He's
said on, bro.
I can see the flipping.
Nah, man. This
bro,
is Stratford.
He said on the album. Hey, listen. He said on the album, I'm growing out my afro like Samson.
Yeah.
He said it. The powers, bro. But I want to see dreads though, Hus. If you're gonna say that.
Yeah. Oh no.
I want to see Hus with dreads.
I want to see dreads.
Yeah, man. I want to get to Tevin's level, man. He used to have short hair. I want to see you grow it out, man.
It's funny that you guys mentioned about the different voices and if you want to call it alter egos of Hus, Crept tweeted saying Hus has like 5 different voices and he can use a few of them on one song and sound like he's featuring himself. Yeah. And Skepta also said, this Hus album is what I needed. Mm. It's so funny you mentioned this. We're obviously going to get to the conversation of charts, whether it'll get number one or not. Before we do, it's only right that we, if you want to do the honors of holding such, that's what is potentially Hus could be getting. Jeez. Again, shout out to Dummy, the whole Disturb in London. That is the number one plaque that was given to Tiny Temper for Written in the Stars.
Oi. Oh, wow. Okay.
The mega, mega, heavy, mega, man. Mega, mega hit.
Smash it.
Heavy.
Absolute mega hit. Yeah.
Solid, though.
Do we feel like as if Hus is going to get that number one spot? And also, what singles can you see breaking the top 10?
Mm-hmm. Who's he up against?
So at this moment now, he's up against
Taylor Swift,
and Rita also Ora. He's up to Rita Ora, yeah. Who's currently
Rita Ora has an album. Olivia Rodrigo as well.
She's got an album called You and I.
We can't let Rita win.
Yeah, sorry, yeah, enough is enough.
I mean, I don't know. Like, I think if everyone in here buys a copy. Mm-hmm. And doesn't stream it and just buys a copy for $9.99.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It'll definitely help.
Do you know what? Fun fact, you know Hus's album Big Conspiracy is the only album I've ever bought on my phone.
Is
ever.
It?
Actually. Ever.
Wow.
So you're snitching on yourself.
Just a fun fact.
Okay. Like, that's cold.
Yeah, because I was supporting from then and it's literally still till this day. You know when like you got a repay for Apple Music and it only goes to what you bought?
Yeah.
All I have is that, oh, is that album. Really? That's the only one I have. That's the only one
I'm gonna add
for.
This one?
Yeah. Of course.
I'm okay. Supporting. All right. All right.
Because recently you hit number one, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
And
it did,
Common Sense.
Common Sense didn't. Yeah. Common Sense
was it
didn't.
Number two, was number two.
I can't remember.
No.
It's a good question.
You need to get Hus.
I think it went number six.
To read some stats for you guys. Whoa. At this moment.
That's crazy.
I think so.
At this moment now, it's currently number two on the UK album charts of when we've recorded with 4,035 sales, and it's predicted to secure the number one album, the number one spot with around projected looking at 30,000 sales. At this moment, Rita Ora's You and I is number one with 4,264 sales, which has boosted heavily because of physicals.
How many sales?
4,264.
Yeah, we need to brush that.
Music's down right now, man.
But those are just on physicals because, you know, like, sorry, that would be on streams. With a lot of physicals, it ends up taking time.
Yeah, yeah, of course, of course.
So are we seeing another music video from Hus, though, from this project? Are we going to see another music
if
video?
If we do,
that's what I want.
I think we should. And if we do, I want to see Nice Body or Masculine.
Yeah, same. Mm.
That's one of the two I want to see if he does a video.
Yeah.
It's funny because at this moment of time of us recording as well.
Isn't he creating the video for Masculine? I saw you.
Yeah, he did.
And if you need extras in the video, I'm here. Could do anything.
Shout out your boy.
Currently right now, if we're looking at the charts, number four at this moment of time is Who Told You with Drake.
Yep.
Number 18 is Militarium with Naira Marley. Number 22, Masculine with Burna Boy. 23 is Nice Body featuring Georgia Smith. 25 is Cream with CB. Number 30, Massacre. Number 34, Palm Tree. And 41, The Intro, The Goat.
Ain't there a free song cap?
The intro's on.
Pardon? Ain't there a free song cap, like, for how many entries are allowed in for one from one album? There isn't.
If it's been streamed so much, then it can just end up going in there.
I think he's doing very well.
DBE was someone who had like pretty much like whole album was in like a top 40. I think Dave had similar as well.
So Sprint is still number one. They can't knock it off
at this moment.
Still number one.
Damn, and I don't see it getting knocked off for another 2-3 weeks. I'll be real.
At this moment,
it's going crazy.
Do you still listen to it?
Yeah. I actually still listen to it.
Do you not? Do you not like Sprinter?
I do like Sprinter.
Yeah.
I do, but it's been out for time. Like, I've rinsed it.
That's how I know I love it, because I've been rinsing it and I still like it.
It's good background music, though.
I prefer Trojan Horse and UK rap. Mm. I still listen to them because I think, like, do you know what it is? Yeah, TikTok is, this is the problem with TikTok. You go on TikTok, you open the app, and then you hear it first. Mm-hmm. You hear Sprinter straight away. You'll hear the first 10 seconds of a song all the time, and it's killing music quickly, bro. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm over that Gunner song, fuck you mean. I've heard it so many times because of TikTok.
Yeah.
Like, TikTok's killing music.
Yeah.
Not because
it reminds
even
me of The Box, Roddy Ricch. That's what it started to remind me of.
Like, exactly.
Fuck you mean.
Exactly. Like, bro,
yeah.
If Pharrell Happy came out in this day and age, I'd kill myself. That song was rinsed. Imagine that would be all over TikTok right now. Like, I can't, seriously. But Sprinter's a great song. Like, and them two, they're superpowers. They've come together like on some serious thing. That's why I feel like Hus and And I've said it, I said it on Kit Game, and I asked Burna Boy, and I re-uploaded the clip just to show people again.
Chase.
I asked him if he would do a collab album with Hus, and he said he would.
100%.
So I feel like if Hus and Burna Boy came together, that's a combination that could take on Cench and Dave.
Yeah.
Definitely. That's some super power shit right there.
Yeah.
Nice. I think the best way for us to overall to round everything up would be if we go around to each person and give a sentence of what they feel on based off of this album and their thoughts on this album.
I would say it is J Hus having fun again, falling in love with music again, making great music, and just bringing different facets of his personality together for us to enjoy.
Okay.
Music?
I'm gonna top that. I would say
it's very good.
Yeah, it's a good kind of roundup of it. I would say I like the album. I'm not in love with it, but I feel like it's because I still need to keep listening to it though. So I'm aware of that, and I'm willing to give it a bit more time for it to marinate. I've got my favorites. I like all the girl tunes, but that's because I just like melodic sounds, and I'm into R&B, and anything that resonates with R&B, I'm into.
You just like
it.
Soft life.
I do. Love soft life.
Come on.
Paris and these things.
All right.
I never said anything.
But I'm happy for Hus. I'm really happy for Hus. I'm happy he's back. I respect him. I respect his talent. I respect everything that he encapsulates. And yeah, in terms of my top three, in terms of like the albums, I would put Big Conspiracy first for sure. Then it would come to this, and then Common Sense at number three. But like I said, still love the album. Well, yeah. Like it, growing to love it. It's probably a grower.
Yeah.
Let's call it a grower.
Yeah.
Makes sense. Flashy?
Yeah, so I'll say it's definitely a rebellious project. Do you know what I mean? Even down to the girl tunes, like, the bars ain't as lovey-dovey.
Yeah, but they don't have to be.
No, they don't have to be. They don't have to be, but I feel like overall theme is dark, and I like dark albums, innit, where men are just like very vulnerable on what's going on in their life, like situations, bar the whole being a father thing, because probably not ready for that. But it's a rebellious and angry project, and I like the aggressiveness that Hus is bringing. Do you know what I mean? Because I like it when Hus is like devil in me, demon, like, do you know what I mean? I like the shock value. But I do think though, like I do think it needs to grow on me. I think it needs to grow on me a bit more, and I think there's quality in the album, innit? And there's no doubt but that J5 magic was missing. I will never deny it. The J5 magic was missing, innit? So that's me.
I would say overall about this is probably one of Hus's album, the best Hus album, that's an oxymoron that covers the two sides towards this. He can develop alter egos from these tunes, and he could even go off and just give us a random person's name, and then that's the alter ego that's now got a full project with these characters and things along these lines. Sonically, I think that Big Conspiracy, sonically and instrumental wise, is his best project. This one, I do feel like, is, as you said, Craig, is his most fun, of where he's just jumping into a comfortable space. Overall, I highly do rate this album. All this album has proved to me as well is that I need one album of Hus just R&B.
When you say R&B, just what do you mean?
What? So like the girl tunes. Melodies and the girl tunes.
I would love that.
Because I'm so invested in that side as well, because the rap side, we've seen that on 15th Day. We've seen that from old school
Even
vacation
EPs.
Days. We've seen that from old school Hus, and we know that rapping wise, when he wants to, he can get into that bag.
Why don't we get a double disc?
I would love that.
We don't really do that as much in
give
the
us,
UK.
Give
double
us a
disc.
Speaker box, love below type of vibe. Yeah. Give me two different albums, two different sounds.
This
as
could
a double
be
disc.
A double disc.
Yeah.
Mm. You think so?
It's long enough, right?
Nah.
I think so. Even
19
the
tracks
as well.
That would have been 9 tracks each.
To some extent.
Yeah. For me, UK rap album of the year so far. I don't care if you lot don't agree with it. Your opinion don't matter. Mine does. And now I'm chatting shit. But I stand by that though. Like, that's for me. There's been some good projects this year.
Yeah.
There have been some good projects here. Shout out to Potter. Shout out to Nines. Clavis dropped a project. But for me, this is the best so far. That's just
how
I feel.
This might be, for me personally, might be a good effort for Hus, but for everyone else, this is great. Great, because the standard's so high for him. He's competing against himself, man. And Sonic,
would you say there's one better than this year?
I would.
Potter, maybe.
Potter, I'm not mad at that.
Because
I'm not mad at
I feel
Potter.
Like the concepts on Potter's album were crazy, bro.
But musically,
and like,
but musically, was it at this level musically? Yeah, because though
I feel like it was even more cohesive than this. Potter's one was more cohesive. It blended more. Do you know what I mean? And the whole real back in style theme was kept throughout.
It blended more.
Because he had no features.
It blended more, but I don't think the production was at this level though.
What?
I don't think it was.
What?
I don't think it was.
Potter's production was 10 out of 10, bro.
Nah.
It might have even been.
It worked for me sonically, like you said. It was a consistent sound, which I loved. But the level of production, the instrumentation on some of these songs here was levels that I couldn't find on Potter's album.
This album could have been rearranged a little bit.
Bro, even Militarian, the level of production on Militarian alone, there's nothing on Potter's album. To me, that's on that level of Militarian.
Do you know what though? Because they cleaned up a lot of the songs that were leaked. Do you feel like it was a bit too polished?
No, what, this?
Yeah.
Nah.
You don't think you could ever get too polished, innit?
Nah. Well, it depends. It fits in so well with this because the input that you're seeing from Venna, the little inputs you're seeing from the composers as well, of just adding that extra key in there, that extra bit of saxophone in there, or just that little input in there.
Sexy sax.
It stands out so much when you look at it.
I'm looking at, Real Back in Star Wars, an album still.
What's your album?
Cold album.
Or Project Features. What's to say? Because I'll say Nina.
Oh, come on, bro.
I'll say Nina.
We love Nines, but it wasn't, bro.
I haven't been that impressed, if I'm honest.
I honestly think it was
Nina.
Then again, for me, I have a very specific sound that I like, though. Mm. So I feel like it's going to be hard for me to comment on that. Yeah. Do you get what I mean? I literally only
Nina's got way better projects than the one he dropped this year. Nina, have you seen Nina's catalogue? It's crazy.
I think it's between Nina or this, to be fair.
Huh?
I think it's between Nina or this.
So you think Nines album's better than Potter's album?
Thank you, Craig, Mitch, for joining us.
So that rounds up this episode of the Control Room. Thank you, guys. Honestly, thank you, Craig, though. Thank Craig, you, Flashy.
Love for having me.
Flashy Sillah.
J Hus is the GOAT.
Thank you, guys.
Before we do round up, please make sure you are buying and supporting Baby.
Because we want to get it to number one.
Facts.
Come on, we got to get J Hus there.
Facts.
Absolutely. Thanks, guys. Thanks.